very distinct type of mucopolysaccharidosis, out of which MPS2 is it follows X-linked inheritance pattern, and rest everything follows autosomal recessive pattern. So mucopolysaccharidosis. In a frequency of greater than 1%, right? But mutation, on the other hand, if you take a considered population, if a single case where a change is occurring less than 1% in a population, it is a mutation. So we focus on the mutation which are present in the intron and the exon, or the exon-intron spanning region, for our lipopolysaccharidosis study, and the promoter and phytonuclear region for our diabetic study. So we do PCR amplification of our genome interest. Then we use the sample sequencing. So after getting the PCR purified product, we have to do PCR purification. So because after the PCR, we'll have buffers, DNTP still remaining in the PCR product, right? So we just require our DNA of interest or gene of interest. So the amplicon of our desired region. So we just purify that PCR product and then we send it for Sanger sequencing. So Sanger sequencing of our gene of interest and analysis of result obtained from the Sanger sequencing. So the result obtained from the Sanger sequencing, we receive it in a format called as FASTA format. So are you all aware of what is a FASTA format? Yeah, so it is a representation of, it is a text-based representation of nucleotide or any amino acid sequences. So we get a result in our FASTA format, and then we use certain software called as a sequencer to analyze our data. So this is how we do our analysis. So we retrieve the reference sequence from NCBI. So it's a database. So or the mutation which was associated. So further, after this analysis, we cannot say that if the mutation or an SNP is causing the disease or not. So for that, we have different tools, the bioinformatics tool. We just go to NCBI. So we have to use certain again tools like gene bar and DDSNPs to see the pathogenicity, if it is actually causing any disease or not. So, and also, you can see the beautiful peaks, so detecting each nucleotide. So it will be easy for us to find if there is any sequence change. So for this, for MPS, we again do the cryo analysis. So it is very important for prenatal diagnosis. So we cryo analysis nothing but patient and the parents, father and the mother. So we just do the PCR amplification of the patient, and if we find any pathogenic mutation, we just go for the same exon for the parents, and then we see if actually the mutation is present in the parents as well or not. So basically ours is an autosomal recessive disorder with the polysaccharidosis. So the peaks which we see will be in heterozygous condition for the parents. So in that way we can tell the parents are carriers for this disease, and then we can caution them for the subsequent pregnancies. So we can just they can go for genetic counseling, and then the prenatal diagnostic can be done, so that they will know the probability of the second child or the